Okay, here we have yet another light source, which happens to be probably my favorite light source as a bulb collector, fluorescent lighting. Today, fluorescent lighting is actually far more common than the good old incandescent. The basic principle of operation in a fluorescent lamp is simple. You have a glass tube, and inside, all you have in the tube at each end are electrodes called cathodes. And in the case of the hot cathode, they're like a little filament. That's why you have two pins on each end, because each pin goes to one end of the filament. And these filaments inside are electrodes that send current through the gas in the lamp. The gas in the lamp is argon, and there's a little bit of mercury in the tube, just a tiny amount, like just a pinhead amount of mercury. And how it works is when the current is switched on, these cathodes heat up, and they're coated with a special material that gives off electrons. It works on the same principle as a vacuum tube, and it's called thermionic emission. When it heats up, it gives off electrons. And that's good because when the filaments heat up, they give off the electrons. Then a high voltage pulse is sent through the lamp from the starter, and that pushes those electrons through the lamp from one end to the other, and it starts an arc through the lamp, through the gas that's in the lamp, which is argon. And this argon arc makes enough heat to vaporize the mercury that's in the tube, and that goes into the arc stream and produces ultraviolet radiation, ultraviolet light. And the ultraviolet light hits a powder on the inside of the tube. That's why they're white. It's called a phosphor. And it's a material that glows when ultraviolet radiation strikes it. So when the UV radiation produced by the arc through the gas in the lamp hits the phosphor, it makes it glow. And that's what produces light. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to start up a nice Sears fluorescent lamp that was made by Westinghouse and branded as Sears. They're actually not common today. That starts in a preheat fixture with a starter, and you'll be able to see the preheating of the lamp when I start it. Okay, here we go. Beautiful start. You see it blinked a couple of times because the lamp didn't catch on the first try, so the starter just reglowed, reheated, closed the contacts, and tried again. And the starter will keep trying until it restarts the lamp. There's a little delay. There's the cathode heat. There's the start. Beautiful start. The starter's really good in this fixture. This is a design that came out in 1939, and it's still with us today, and it's unbeaten in reliability. The reason why they have different colors, warm white, cool white, even solid colors like pink and blue and green. The reason why they create different colors is just because there's different blends of the chemicals used in the phosphors. Like for example, if you took the phosphor for the blue lamp and mixed it in a certain proportion with the phosphor from a pink lamp, you could get a white lamp. And in fact, this cool white lamp I have in my hand has a specific blend of the blue phosphors and the pink phosphors, and it emits a white light by blending them in a certain balance. So the blue and the reds balance together and produce a white light. Of course, there's other colors emitted too, but blue and red are the predominant colors. And the simplicity of the lamp is its advantage. Another advantage is it doesn't get hot. The ends get a little hot to the touch because of the filaments, but not hot enough to burn you. The center only runs lukewarm because the current flowing through the gas produces mostly ultraviolet light, and it's at low pressure, so it doesn't produce a lot of heat, which is an advantage because fluorescent lamps can produce a lot of light on very little energy. For general lighting inside of buildings, for white light, fluorescence cannot be beat in efficiency. And it doesn't matter whether you have an old fixture from the 1940s that uses starters and has ancient electrical gear inside of it, or the most modern electronic ballasts, the efficiency of the lamps hasn't changed much over the years. The disadvantages are few. Maybe sometimes contact issues, they don't want to start sometimes, things like that. If you turn the lamp on and off frequently, it can shorten its life. The color quality of the light isn't as good as incandescent. That's another disadvantage. But otherwise, really, their advantages outweigh their disadvantages.